Hey guys, Alex from 7th Hour Films back again with Mr. Robot. Last time on Mr. Robot, we had EPS3.6 underscore Frederick plus Tanya.CHK. I think, is that CHK? I think so. It's very tiny text on the monitor. Let's see what all happened. Well, we had the aftermath of stage two. Elliot is freaking the frick out about it, and Mr. Robot switched over, and he's kind of freaking out about it because he's angry because his revolution has been perverted into something else. Angela is losing her mind because she thinks that White Rose will be able to save everyone that died, and Darlene's having to deal with that. Meanwhile, Dom is having bad luck over at the FBI with Terrell. And then throughout the entire episode, we also had Mobley and Trenton, who were being watched over by Leon until eventually he handed them over to the right hand, who White Rose's right hand. White Rose's right hand. Say that three times when you're drunk. And then they basically became the Fall Guys. They were killed, and they look like they were the ones responsible for the Stage 2 attacks. So, yeah, Mobley and Trenton are dead now. And Dom immediately knows that they are the Fall Guys for White Rose. But it seems like all hope is lost now. The hell do we do? So, yeah. That was basically that. All around, it was a good, fun episode. But yeah, so let's see what we're in store for today as we get into this episode of Mr. Robot. Here we go. Oh, it's back in the day.
It's okay. I'll get it out of my system before the movie. Don't you worry. Here. All right, dump them on in.
I like little Elliot with a little hoodie.
Come on. You know what to do.
Don't know. Why do people always ruin popcorn in TV and movies?
I want to go home.
How long are you going to be mad at me? I told you I was sorry.
You're not sorry.
Oh, it was after the window.
You don't admit it.
You're right.
It's so weird to see him as a real person.
I made some mistakes. All I'm asking is that you forgive me. Think you'll ever be able to do that?
No.
Oh, damn. Oh.
Somebody call 911.
Oh, that's not good. Yeah, he's got the arm in the sling. I'm sorry, I'm slightly distracted by the... by the movie theater. This place looks awesome. Where is he going, though? Left with the jacket. Is Casper playing?
Welcome. Your movie will begin shortly.
God.
Please keep our theaters clean by disposing of your trash in the specified waste container.
Oh, I haven't been to a movie in so long. Last movie I went to was Sonic the Hedgehog. And I got into a wreck after that. My arm was in a thing.
Enjoy the show.
Oh, that's clever. That's a good opening. Wait. Are we just in widescreen now? Oh man, I'm gonna have to remember to edit that.
When you delete something, you're making a choice to destroy it.
Why is it this show looks 80 times better just with two little black bars on it? Oh, he's breaking it. Wipe the whole stuff.
You need to talk to Angela. She is not doing well. Last time I saw her, she was going through a full-on breakdown.
I don't care. She should be breaking down.
Aw, damn.
Nice. I recall her being there for you when you had your little episode. Multiple times.
Guess I'm an asshole.
What does it even matter, Darlene?
Technically, he
didn't. He got what he wanted. Didn't he? Except, wait a minute. Nope. E-Corp's still gonna be just fine. Because of E-Corp. But he sure didn't see that coming, did he? Whoops! Oh well. Consolation prize.
He won't leave. Because I wanted this.
Well, yeah.
Deletion. When you make that decision, there's always that moment of hesitation.
Yeah, this feels like he's
that
cutting.
Annoying, are you sure dialogue box?
Cutting her out.
And then you have to make a call. Maybe it's something I should have done a long time ago.
Get rid of the jacket. But will that be enough?
Just wanted to pay my respects.
That fat fuck doesn't deserve respect from anyone. You know how much he's damaged my career?
But don't believe the lies you read about him.
Well.
They're not true.
It's been all over the news. What, you think they just make this shit up now? The facts are there.
Yeah, actually.
He was working with the Iranians. There's no way I was gonna pay for a terrorist funeral.
Well, all right then. Maybe try Trenton. 7-1. 7-1 is the next 5-9.
Shama was a victim. Somebody did this to her. This country now blames Muslims for everything. There's no room for us here anymore.
Damn. I mean,
thank you for saying nice things about my daughter.
Yeah. It's sad, but he knows his daughter is innocent.
It's a lot of pills. Are you sick?
Oh, hey, the brother.
Go down the street, take the train.
I don't know how to do that.
Is he in his mind?
How did you get here?
I followed you.
Maybe he's not. Maybe he's legit. Would they already leave?
Where are your parents?
My uncle lives there. He likes to live by the mall. He's bald.
This is serious. I can't sit here for 2 hours.
That's what I'm telling you. We should go to the movies.
This. Elliot, I would just leave him.
I take you to the movies.
Oh my god.
Where am I going if something good is playing?
Oh, all three Back to the Futures? That's incredible.
Back to the Future. Can we see The Martian instead?
The Martian's pretty good.
Are you kidding? You've never seen Back to the Future?
There's a lot of cosplayers out here too.
Looks like an old movie.
You don't understand. Today's the day that Marty travels into the future. I've wanted to see this movie on this day since I was your age.
Wait, today? Isn't that in
so rare that it's
October? Today. Why would you do this to popcorn? Why? They did that on Whiplash too. Just eat the popcorn.
What are you doing? You just ruined it.
Finally.
This is the best way to eat popcorn.
Well, I guess if this is Back to the Future Day, it makes sense that... Makes sense that there's a lot of people in costumes.
Wow. That's good.
No shit. Come on.
And we're back to the movies.
You can't go into the future to change the past. It's way heavier than that. He goes into the future to change the future. But that allows Biff to change the past, which changes the future again.
No, spoilers!
No, it's much simpler than that. It's about how one mistake can change the world.
Well, wait, are you guys specifically watching Back to the Future Part 2?
Are you sure we can't see The Martian?
Come on, you're gonna love it.
Wait a minute, this kid's starting on Part... You can't start on Part 2! Watch... You gotta watch Part 1 first. Oh. How is this kid gonna understand part two if he doesn't see part one? What are we doing here?
Put on the jacket and the shoes. Got a mission to accomplish.
Where'd the kid go? Hi.
What? Try me.
Looking for a mosque. It's near a playground.
Masjid al-Rahman or the Islamic Society?
Either.
Come on, we'll figure it out.
Due to the inescapable assumption that those strange beings who landed in the Jersey farmland tonight are the vanguard of the invading army.
War of the Worlds? Yeah.
Why not?
Play that on
the end of the world.
That's incorrect.
Play that on October 30th.
For a while, but
cool, okay? I gotta go.
Is it that important?
Yes.
Why?
It's none of your business.
You're a baby.
You're annoying.
You are.
This is a nightmare.
You are.
So are you.
I wish you were dead.
So do I.
Oh, is that where it... That was he was doing?
It wasn't your fault. Or hers. It was mine. All of it. So don't blame her or yourself. You can blame me.
Did you know I could be president of the United States? I'm the only person in my family who could be president. Isn't that cool?
I guess.
If I were president, I'd put the real bad guys in jail. And I'd make everyone eat Pop-Tarts for dinner. And I'd make everyone be nice to me.
Good luck with that.
He'd be a dictator.
What's a dictator?
It's like a really bad president. New Jersey?
Really? Me too. What part?
Washington Township. Where were you born?
Trenton.
Oh. That makes sense.
Because you said you were sick.
Oh.
Probably change your corporate email password. Using your street address, even if it's an old one, isn't the smartest.
Ooh.
Don't feel special. I hack everyone. From the emails I found,
yeah.
You and your law firm swapped some shady memos I don't think the IRS would look too kindly on.
That's old
what
school.
What do you think you found? If you don't want me sending them out, make sure your brother gets a funeral. A good one. Start writing a eulogy. Good one. I'll be in the back, listening.
Oh, man. That's some classic Elliot right there.
Remember when we used to do our wishing game? We'd close our eyes, and we'd wish for something. We both wish we could get bigger bedrooms. That was a big one. You would always wish for more protractors, which was weird. Closed our eyes really hard, hoping that when we opened them, it'd all come true. We thought the harder we closed them, the stronger our wishes would be. Even though they never came true, we still liked doing it. The ending was never our favorite part anyway.
Aww.
It's not always permanent.
Oh my gosh.
Maybe there are still things left for me to do.
She sent it to Elliot. Oh my gosh! Okay. I mean, I hesitate to call this a feel-good episode, but it's a, sort of a feel-better episode, you know? Okay. Man, oh man. That was really good, man. That was really good. I don't know what it is about adding the two black bars across the top that make everything look so cinematic, you know? Oh. Okay. So, perhaps we have just the slightest ray of hope in that email. That was a really good episode, and a very necessary episode, definitely. Like, that... I feel reinvigorated, man. Like, last episode I was so down, you know? I was so down and out, which, I mean, you're supposed to. It's incredible that, you know, I went through the exact same, like... arc, basically. I mean, not the same arc, but like a similar experience to Elliot, you know, which that's the sign of brilliant writing, you know. Last episode, like Elliot, I was down. I was just, you know, I was down. I was depressed. I was like, what, whatever. I'm done. But now, thanks to this episode, I'm back. And so is Elliot, you know. Oh. What a good episode, man. What a good episode. Now I did say this at the end, but I do need to... I need to make sure that I was correct about this. Did Trenton send that to Elliot, specifically? Or did she send it to someone, but then Elliot found it, you know? He went through and found... He went through and found the email she sent. So, I'm not sure. I'm not really sure if... I'm not really sure if that's the case. Either they'll clear it up next episode, or maybe you guys can clear that up in the comments. Either way, Elliot has the email. He knows what's happening. So, yes, they did find a way. There is a way to undo the hack, to undo everything. And now Elliot has found it. And maybe that's what Mr. Robot needs, you know? Maybe this could bring Mr. Robot around. Because, I mean, the thing is, it's like Elliot said, you know? It's like, oh, E-Corp is being taken down, except it's not. Thanks to E-Coin, E-Corp will recover. You know, and that was the whole thing we heard last week was, you know, E-Corp will recover, but Philip Price won't specifically. All this has done is taken down Philip Price, but not taken down E-Corp, you know? Oh, excuse me. So, yeah. Okay, so... The brother was real. I was like sitting here for a while. And I was like, is he? I don't know. Maybe he's in Elliot's head, but no. The brother was real. Well, I mean, I guess it's still open for debate, but I'm gonna say it's pretty it's pretty safe to say the brother was real, you know? I mean, that's the thing. We have an unreliable narrator, so I can never trust when someone's real and someone isn't, you know? But I'm gonna make the safe assumption that the brother was real. So, what was his name, specifically? Just so I don't keep calling him the brother. Muhammad. Okay, we can work with that, so. I might still go back and forth between Muhammad and the brother, so. Yeah. Not a lot of cast members on this one, actually. That's interesting. Anyway, so, first off, good framing of good framing of this episode, starting with the movie aspect of it, which is good. And man, I gotta say, if I can have a slight little tangent here, I said in the reaction, the last movie I saw in theaters was Sonic the Hedgehog, and that was right before everything with the pandemic and stuff, and I still haven't gone to see another movie. Probably the next one I was thinking I was going to go see Black Widow when that came out in theaters. Because I think that's actually coming out on my birthday. So I was just like, oh, I'll go see that. So maybe. Well, I'll see. But and the other thing about that is, while I was driving home from Sonic the Hedgehog, I actually got into a wreck. And it sprained my arm. It didn't fracture anything. I didn't break anything. I didn't fracture anything. It sprained my wrist, basically, because I was, like, holding on, and so it did damage. But it sprained it so bad that they thought it fractured, and it was only, like, on the x-rays. They were like, oh, well, it's not, it's just sprained, but it was so bad. So seeing young Elliot at the movie theater. First off, the movie theater is nostalgic for me, but also him because he has his arm in a sling because that was after the accident. You get the idea. So because it was after that is like, it's bringing back memories. I can still feel my arm is completely healed up. Like, I'm all good. It was only a few weeks that I had to keep my arm in a cast, basically. That was a rough view. You can actually go see, there are plenty of videos that, because of, you know, obviously I kept recording, but there were plenty of videos where I just had my arm in a thing and it was like laying on pillows and I was writing with my left hand. So there's quite a few videos where, my arm is in a sling, or in a, cast, but that was so, what was I gonna say? But it did heal up. It's all good now. However, and I wonder if anyone else can attest to this, my right arm still doesn't feel 100%. Like, I can feel in that wrist, it feels different than it used to be, you know? And it feels different from my left arm, which is my left wrist, which is completely fine. So, just a little tangent, you know, Mr. Robot bringing up some memories for me. So, yeah. But anyway, but that still was a good, that was still a good opening scene, and then using that as the framing device for the episode. Like, oh yeah, now you're watching a movie. I'm watching a movie with subtitles, though. That's the one thing about, you know, the past year and a half, the only time I've watched movies has been, you know, from the comfort of my own home, like on streaming and stuff. I will say, I feel like I've been spoiled with subtitles, and when I go back to the theater, I'm not going to have that anymore, and I'm definitely going to miss that, because I am so spoiled on subtitles. I mean, you guys know, I watch, if I have the option, I will watch, I'll do these reactions with subtitles, because it's just better, you know? Now, luckily, because of the aspect ratio of this one, I imagine the way I edited this video is that I did crop out the black bars, so that will also have cropped out the subtitles from this episode. But yeah, so that is definitely going to be one thing I'm gonna have to get used to again if I go back to a movie theater, is watching a movie without subtitles. So, oh well. Anyway, so good framing for the movie, for the episode. Also, I'll just go ahead and say, I don't understand putting, and it looked like they put M&Ms in, it looked like M&Ms that were being put into the popcorn. I remember when I reacted to the movie Whiplash, they also did something like that. I think those were Milk Duds, though, where they put a bunch of Milk Duds into popcorn, and even then I was like, why are you doing this to a perfectly good bowl of popcorn, you know? So, I don't know. I've never tried it. I don't think it would be good, you know? That's just the thing. So, I don't think I'd be like the kid. So, anyway. So, we also had the talk with Darlene, And it's like, oh, well, Mr. Robot should be happy, shouldn't he? No, he shouldn't, because E-Corp will recover. And it's interesting, you know, Elliot saying all of this, like, the reason Mr. Robot keeps going, the reason that everything still happens is because Elliot does like it, you know? Despite the fact that they are two distinct personalities, they do work off each other. They are similar, you know? It's just that Mr. Robot is really just the extreme side of Elliot, personified, you know? So, that's the thing. That's the thing. But Elliot still, I mean, we've had that for a while, that he does like it. He is tempted by this stuff, you know? So, it is pretty rough. It is very difficult. But I'm really, really hoping that we can get the two of them talking again, you know? Because they haven't really talked to each other since season two, you know? They've been separated most of this season, so hopefully we can get back to that a bit, you know? Anyway. We did have the morphine, which was interesting. I'm guessing that going to the beach, and, you know, he kept saying, it's like, oh, I need to go to Coney Island. There's something I got to do. I'm assuming that is he was going to overdose on morphine and die specifically. They never come right out and say it. Like, the closest is, you know, when he's like, oh, I wish you were dead. Well, so do I, you know? So I think that's it, that he was going to use the morphine to overdose and die, basically. Basically deleting both himself and Mr. Robot. So that was interesting. And obviously, because of this whole situation with the kid, that's been stopped. Now, I will say, because with the idea that the kid wasn't in his head, that means everything wasn't in his head. Which, again, I kind of struggle with that a bit, because then you get the very helpful, happy ice cream vendor, and it's just like, what the hell's going on here? This guy just, he's happy, he's listening to War of the Worlds, he's serving ice cream at, like, midnight. Alright, cool. Also, it's October now? But that makes... Yeah, because it's October. That's the thing. They're playing all three Back to the Future movies, but that is in October. It's October 21st, I think? Oh, now I gotta look it up, just to be sure. Okay. Now I gotta look it up, just to be sure. Back to the Future Day. I was right. Back to the Future Day is October 21st, and he went to 2015 specifically. Now, I thought they said, I thought that they said that the attack, stage two, was on September 1st. Maybe I'm just wrong. No, wait, that was a 7, not a 9. That was 71 buildings. I'm an idiot. Okay, so it was later in... The attacks were later in September, and now it's October 21st, Back to the Future. October 21st, 2015, Back to the Future Day. Okay, now I get it. Now, okay. Sorry, the 7-1 threw me off, but yeah. I will admit, I always get September and July confused when it comes to numbers. So, I think that's because, you know, July is 7, September is 9, but then my birthday is July 9th, so it's 7-9, but then I get that mixed up, so it's a whole thing that probably only applies to me, but yeah, so. Anywho. Actually... Wait a minute. Wait just a darn second. So I'm recording this on June 23rd, but that means it'll go out to Patreon on July 2nd, which means it's going to go up to YouTube on July 9th. This episode's going up on my birthday. Oh, well, happy birthday to me. That's a weird thing to say. Yes, if you are watching this on the day it was uploaded to YouTube, today is my 24th birthday. So, okay. Wow, that's hilarious that on the episode that we bring up, like, my birthday and stuff, this is actually going up on my birthday. That's hilarious. Anywho, we had, like, a long train of thought. The morphine, I guess that's what we were on last. We also had Elliot trying to pay his respects, which, that was an interesting thing. First off, just seeing, the contrast between the families, you know, Mobley's brother, you know, saying, it's like, oh, you know, of course that worthless piece of crap would get wrapped up in that. He's a terrorist. I'm not going to give him a funeral or anything. But then you go over to Trenton's family. And that was pretty interesting that it was, yes, obviously, you know, they're angry and stuff, but they understand she is innocent, which I thought was very interesting, you know? They know she's innocent. She wouldn't do something like this. And, you know, it's the Americans that are pinning this on a Muslim, you know? So that was interesting. And I do like, you know, Elliot starts to leave and then the dad says, thank you for saying nice things about my daughter, you know? So it's one of those things. Yes, obviously, they're angry. They're in mourning, you know, but they understand that they know their daughter as opposed to Mobley's brother, you know? So, yeah. But then we got the whole plotline with the brother, which was interesting. And this brother that's just sticking around with Elliot for some reason. And then they go off and see... And that was the strange thing. They start to go see Back to the Future Part 2. But... And it's like, oh, yeah, you're going to like the movie. Yeah, and it's great. It's about going to the future to change the past. And then again, I love all the cosplayers, you know, getting into arguments about, like, what it really is and stuff. And it's like, yeah, but why are you starting the kid on part two? You can't start on part two. You have to watch part one, you know? You have to watch part one. Otherwise, you're not going to understand part two. So, I get it because, you know... It was Back to the Future Day, and, you know, that means it's the moment from part two. I get that, but the framing of it is, Elliot took the kid to go see part two without watching part one first. That was weird. That was definitely weird. Also, definitely go watch The Martian. The Martian was a good movie, you know? The Martian was a good movie, so... But, I mean, Back to the Future is a better movie, but still. That's neither here nor there. Why start at Back to the Future Part 2? Like, I get it works for the plot, but still. Anyway. But then we had the revelation, you know, that Elliot, you know, basically wanted to die. And, you know, that's the safe assumption that he was going to use the morphine in order to overdose and die, basically. That's why he gave the dog to the landlord and everything. And, you know, he was squaring things away before he ended it all. So that was interesting. And, yeah, we had the whole thing of, you know, it's not your fault, it's not her fault, it's my fault that this stuff is happening, you know? I like to talk about the presidents, you know. It's like, oh, this is what I would do if I was president. And now it's like, oh, so you'd be a dictator then, you know? So... I mean, that's the thing, you know, when it's like, oh, I would make sure that everyone likes me. It's like, oh, good fucking luck with that. I don't think any politician's ever gotten that, you know? So that's the thing. But yeah, but that whole talk was just very interesting to listen to, you know? So yeah, and then when he says, like, oh, yeah, I was also born in New Jersey. It's like, oh, where? Trenton. It's like, that's where she got the name. That's very clever. We had Elliot with the funeral. That was very good. A classic Elliot moment when he's like, yeah, I hacked you. Don't worry, you're not special. I hack everyone. That was really funny. But yeah, blackmailing him into giving Mobley a good funeral. So that was really good. I like that. And then we had the talk with Angelo, which I liked. Him going over and then, you know, saying all of that. The whole story with the wishes was really good. So, I really liked that. That was a good emotional scene. You know, and for Angela, who, I mean, I kind of, after everything that's happened with E-Corp and the Dark Army and stuff, I've kind of, I don't know, it's sort of painted Angela more as a bad guy, but I like that, that moment was good of reminding you, it's like, well, she's not really a bad guy per se, it's just that she's someone who has made choices, you know? She's made her choices, and she has to live with them, but she's still a person. She's still our friend, and we do need to reach out to her, you know? So I did like that. And then we had Don't Delete Me. Elliot did go back, got the dog and everything, went, and again, I'm not sure if Trenton specifically sent the email to him or if he found the email that she sent. But he has the email now, a way to undo this, which is sort of our ray of hope, basically. So yeah, don't delete me. There could be a way to undo everything. So yeah, good episode. Really, really good episode. I really enjoyed it. And again, you know, a good, very emotional episode, in certain aspects. A bit weird. It's like, all right, here's this kid that won't leave us alone, and here's this random ice cream truck driver listening to War of the Worlds and stuff. So that was interesting. You know, it was just kind of strange, but still very good. And especially after last episode, like, this is exactly what both we and Elliot needed, I think. It's like, last episode, you're so down. You're beaten to hell. And this one is like, hey, we can make it through this. You know, let's pick ourselves back up and let's keep going. So, I'm glad for that. This was a really great episode. And I'm curious to see where we're going next. We have two episodes left of this season before we get into the final season. So, yes, let's see where we're going next. But that is basically it. With all that being said, I'm Alex from 7th Hour Films, and I will see you guys next time. Take care. Alright guys, thanks for watching this video. If you want to watch more of my Mr. Robot reactions, there is a playlist on screen if you want to go check that out. There's also another video on screen if you want to go watch more of my reactions and such. There's a subscribe button, a Patreon button, as well as other links in the description. See you guys next time.